Amit Bawa, who's the managing director of SAP in India and the Asian subcontinent. And thank you, Mr. Bawa, for joining the BW People HRS Excellence Summit and Award. Mr. Bawa is also the jury chair of the BW People HR Excellence Awards. So thank you, Mr. Bawa, for chairing the jury and selecting the winners. We wanted to do this conversation to contextualize what's happening in the HR domain, what's happening in the business of work, how's it changing, how's the role of HR changing. Let me start by asking you, you know, we're talking almost 12 months after COVID has been there, and a lot has changed since then. What has changed and what remains the same?
Yeah. Thank you, Anurag. Firstly, thanks for having me here, and it's a pleasure, right? It's a pleasure to be part of the jury. Like I said, yes, these have been strange times, right? If I can call it that, we are living in exciting times. Of course, the world is getting flatter than ever before, and I think to your point of what has changed. Change is the only constant, right, today, the way I look at it. And organizations today very clearly need to constantly evolve or reinvent themselves, right? Which is what we saw, you know, in the last 1 year, essentially to stay relevant, to meet expectations of the market. And I guess, you know, to the point that this does warrant a lot of things, you know, that we are seeing around us through the pandemic, both individually, from an individual perspective, as well as from an organization perspective. There is a culture of learning that has changed from the way we had learned it initially. I think leadership styles, while the basic tenets of leadership don't change, but I just think, you know, the fundamentals remain the same, but we've all had to tweak a lot of ways in which we lead today. I know I took over SAP. I came on the helm of almost, I think it was exactly 8 months ago, in the midst of the pandemic. And it's been different, to say the least, Anurag. You know, trying to build trust and credibility and relationships across a screen with people you've never met. Right? It's not the way we've grown up. It's not the way we've learned to sharpen the saw over the years. But loads and loads of learning, and I'll pause for more of your questions. But yes, it's been different times, and I guess all of us have learned and evolved in the last 1 year, Anurag.
Thank you, Gurmeet. The two cues I take there, one is the constant nature of learning new skills and, you know, new ways of being. Second is the fact that we have to engage with stakeholders without being able to meet them, and you know, when you're doing this for the first time, you know, it is not the same as knowing the person for a while. I think these are two definite trends that have happened. Now let me focus on when you work with your HR head, your HR leader, what is the kind of conversations that you as the CEO have with the CHRO? You know, I want a real slice of what is the role of the CHRO, and especially its interface with the CEO.
Yeah, no, that's a great segue, and especially because I said that things are changing so fast, and you know, we've all had to learn and sharpen the saw. Look, to me, Anurag, and I know we discussed this earlier, but you know, the HR function, and I'll come to the CHRO, but the HR function in itself has always held a very prime importance, right? And is key to the functioning or the smooth functioning of any organization, SAP included. And I've always looked at HR as this execution engine, you know, responsible for realizing the vision of the organization or translating the vision that, you know, top management may be setting. How do you, they are the ones responsible for translating some of that into reality. Of course, to your point, as in our CHRO, working in tandem, working very closely with me at every step of the way, right? So to me, you know, when I look at SAP and the CHRO here and the HR team as a whole, I guess they are the bridge between me and the workforce, as would be with any organization, right? A bridge that needs to carry that that very balanced view, which is very, very important, be sort of a maker-checker, you know, as part of their function. Now, you know, we to your first point, what you started with or what you alluded to, I think there's been a lot of change. Change has been the only constant. And this change could have many facets, Anurag, you know, based on the stage of business or the kind of transformation that organizations have had to undergo in the last 1 year or from an SAP perspective. And these changes could range from anything from cultural and mindset changes, behavioral changes, down to, you know, the other end of the spectrum, which to me is just sharpening of the saw or day-to-day processes, which is more tactical. And in most of these, my HR team and the CHRO, I guess they've occupied a very pivotal role, right? A very pivotal role, one by virtue of, you know, HR as a function, being responsible for the entire employee life cycle, you know, from recruitment to onboarding to training to retirement. I guess that whole gamut is the HR responsibility. And second and more important, and I always say this, the human, the word human, part of the human resource is so critical, right? Because it's all about bringing these changes, the transformation that I was talking about, ensuring empathy at any given point, ensuring the appreciation and the pride of place for diverse thoughts and diverse perspectives, right? So it's so important, which is what I saw our HR teams do so beautifully, to actually support the employees through these trying times so that there is proper alignment to the vision. And like I said, you know, from an SAP perspective, we are at that cusp of, you know, we are in the midst of a transition, Anurag, you know, to becoming a true cloud company, because that is the critical need for the hour. That is exactly what our customers have been coming back to us with. So while we are investing billions of dollars towards R&D, towards becoming a cloud company, towards creating our next round of legacy at SAP, and as you can guess or imagine, it's not a technology transition, right? Transitions or transformations like this are holistic in nature. They need a difference in mindset, thought, agility, nimbleness, stuff that we may not have been used to. And I think a lot of this has happened thanks to our HR team, our CHRO, you know, in ensuring this smooth implementation of the change or transition, whether it is, you know, adding brand new mindset or genre of employees with that new mindset, or just upskilling or reskilling our existing teams in these new areas, or keeping them motivated, or just helping people get inspired as we navigate or march towards, you know, our new tomorrow or the ambitious goals that we've set. So I think the HR has been a true a partner in crime as we've gone through some of this, Anurag.
Thank you so much. Now let me focus, you know, technology and technology tools have become much more important in our life, especially when it comes to work over the last 12 months. We are now talking through this video platform. There are multiple video platforms that one can use. So all I'm trying to ask you is, as the role of technology grows, how do you bring in human touch? How do you bring compassion? How do you bring the ability to be able to, you know, touch someone, so to say? So, you know, one cannot ignore the positive aspect of technology, but how do you still say human-centric and bring human touch in everything you do as a leader and as an organization?
Yeah. No, thanks a lot. And in fact, two parts to the way I'll answer it, Anurag. One, of course, you know, and I've said this several times, it's all about people, right? Finally, whether it's internal, external, upwards, downwards, customers, the employees, if you can get the whole people equation right, I think success is easy, right? And a lot of your dreams always get fulfilled. And I'm infamous for saying this, but to your point, look, we have been in transition. Lots of organizations we've seen over the last year have had to reinvent, get back to the drawing board in various ways, right? whether it is making changes to their structures or processes or just the way of working, right? A lot of organizations, as you know, have had to create or invent new business models or pivot to new business models, right? While others have been reborn, you know, they've almost gone into an oblivion and then again been reborn with a new added rigor, right? And reinvented themselves. But I think very, very important to your point, and even at SAP, like I mentioned, so while we undergo such transformational initiatives, right, at whatever level, we cannot let go of the basic tenets, you know, like organizational ethos or belief systems, because that is truly critical to what we do. And it's important to bring in the changes that you were talking about by keeping the moral fabric, if I could call it that, you know, by keeping the moral fabric of an organization intact. Only then these changes become truly worthwhile, and only then can, you know, we be truly successful if we don't get the empathy piece that I was talking about. And as you notice, and I can give you tons of examples, but as you notice, you know, organizations that have embraced this change by taking people along, by ensuring that you know, everyone in the org is rowing in the same direction, rather than by leaving them behind, you know, have definitely built themselves, Anurag, to last longer, right? They've created a much stronger value system. They've created stupendously loyal workforces, right? Which can actually continue to hold these organizations in good stead and to ensure success in the future years. And like I said, even at SAP, you know, we've transformed across a variety of pillars, whether it was the adaptation of workforce skills or bringing in technology to your point, to integrate into business processes. So a lot of that has happened in the last 1 year. But however, I you know, I'm proud to say, and you can feel it in the passion when I talk, but you know, we've ensured very well that organizational transformation happens in consonance with our employee welfare, right? Always making it a point to keep our employees, or as I call it, the heartbeat of the organization, always front and center in what we do, Anurag. So yes, it's super critical to you know, keep a balance between the changes and transformation, whether it's technology or any other way, and to keep the moral fiber, the basic tenets of an organization and the people front and center always, Anurag.
Beautiful. You know, if the organization is truly human-centric, it has a positive impact on all aspects of the company and the society. Now, since this is a human resource-led initiative, this is the BW People HR Excellence Summit and Awards, I just want to ask, within human resources, the use of technology for all domains has gone up, whether it's identifying talent, onboarding talent, recruiting talent, in terms of performance management. The role of learning, as you said, has gone up because learning cycles are shortened. You need to learn new skills. So clearly, technology in human resources, tech in HR, has really gone up. What do you think will it lead to? What are the areas you see an improvement because of technology in human resource function going up?
Yeah. No, great question, Anurag, and you know, I alluded to it earlier, but it's always about a balance to me, right? So not just the HR function, but any form of leadership that you see, it's always a balance. So we will have technology, we will have you know, new avatars coming in, but how do we still manage to keep people, like you said, front and center? And I don't think we have an option, right? So whether I look at customer centricity, right? So if it's SAP or any organization, you have to keep the softer areas of, you know, customers in the center, whether it's your business or mine. Similarly, internally with employees. Now, coming to your point, look, I said this, the world is getting flatter by the day, right? And change is the only constant all around us. And today we don't have a choice. And let's face it, and this has become a stark reality. It's like become a, you know, it's come and hit us in our face in the last 6 to 12 months, right? So we have to constantly evolve. We have to continuously reinvent to stay relevant. And to your point, one of the finest and the sharpest and the fastest ways to do that today is to harness technology, right? And what I have seen, of course, is that, you know, these changes that we are seeing all around us, Anurag, is it also warrants a culture of continuous learning, you know, within the workforce, if I can call it that. So irrespective of function or experience or which area in the organization you are at, I guess everyone needs to learn at scale, right? Which, to your point on technology, all of us, and I'm seeing this name arise more than ever, you need to create learning platforms, right? Taking the help of technology, create learning platforms, build relevant content within that platform, right? Which helps an employee remain productive. And that productiveness is not just in their current roles, but to me, it's very important for them to prepare for the future because of the manner in which the world is moving so quickly. And for example, at SAP, we've got a fantastic platform called OpenSAP, which is an online learning platform with more than 5 million individuals, you know, have already been trained, or 5 million, not individuals, but they've been training imparted almost 5 million times. Now the second aspect, you know, while we talked about technology, I guess is always to this continuous learning is the whole experiential aspect of this, Anurag. Because, you know, today, whether it's SAP or loads of other smarter organizations, they're driving experiential learning through initiatives like, you know, either stretch assignments or internal fellowships is something big for us. Job rotation of early talent. I think this helps immensely, right, in providing that exposure and building the whole well-rounded individual that we are so looking for, or the leadership of tomorrow. And my last point here is, of course, being custodian, since you said this is an HR summit, you know, that we are talking about. I think the custodians of, you know, these employees, or like I said, the heartbeat of an organization, or the most precious resources, I guess, is with HR, right? So they are the custodians. So, and by virtue of that, I think they are so well poised. The HR individuals or professionals are so beautifully poised to identify these skill gaps that we are talking and helping people, employees, workforce, truly design their career paths, thereby bringing the vision that I was talking about, that I may be setting, right? I could set the vision, we could get people to have a shared vision, but it's the HR that are actual custodians who actually help realize that vision, Anurag. Long answer, sorry, but those are my feelings.
Perfect. Thank you for being detailed about it. My last question to you is, if you had to predict, you already talked about continuous learning, the need to upgrade, the need to be human-centric, the need to be able to, in some way, you know, use technology as a leapfrogging tool, but not take the humans out of the equation. But if you had to predict two or three trends from a future of workplaces, in the future of HR standpoint, what would those be?
Yeah. Look, Anurag, one of it is what I said. Yeah. So the harnessing of technology needs to happen sooner than later, but keeping the right balance, keeping the mix between, you know, we don't want a world like 1984, right, where Big Brother's watching you. So we don't want that world. But however, we do want the right mix to come in every facet, right, of an organization. And like I said, you know, HR is the closest, this function is closest to the organization's workforce. And I'll relate it back to the future of work, like you said. They understand the pulse of the organizations better than anyone, hopefully, right? And that's what I've always believed. They're instrumental in actually steering the entire ship, or getting the organization to work as a single fighting unit. Now, to your point, I think some of the things that I'm seeing is, and again, I'll touch technology for just a second, but all the steps in the hire to retire process, which is connected or linked to employees or individuals, need to be made smarter, right? Back to my point, we don't have a choice today. right? Keeping that mix, of course, or the balance correct. Number two, I think apart from this, more and more today, you know, with and what we've seen in the whole work from home in the last 1 year, with lots and lots of organizations, it's tougher to build the vibrancy, you know, or motivation or inspiration in an organization, as well as it's getting tougher to build the psychological safety, which is so critical, right? So I think that's the second bit I would call out, because the safe environment, Anurag and everyone, is clearly that help, something that helps employees deliver their best, right? It actually helps build a culture of you know, where there's no fear of failure, a culture of experimentation. So that's the second piece that I would call out, where organizations are heading, and it's better to embrace it, build that culture of experimentation where people don't have a fear for failure, allow them to fail, allow them to play for failure, which is so important. And lastly, you know, probably I would always call out, I think what's super critical from a future perspective is to get the correct mix in an organization from a diversity perspective. Now, I don't mean, typically we sound, it's cliche, right? Gender or generational diversity, but let's think beyond, right? Just diversity of thought and approach becomes so critical as we move on. And while we ensure that, I think it's super critical, Anurag, that we truly weave, you know, inclusivity into the fabric of the organization. And I mean this, intrinsically weave it into the organization, and not just at a superficial level that we find sometimes. So of course I have one thought for all the HR leaders here, but I'll hand over back to you. I guess visionary leaders, not just HR leaders, are always thinking of the future of work, to your point, helping businesses create that talent pool, not just for today, but to embrace the market shifts and you know, pandemics that we are hit by so often.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bawa. That was Mr. Kulmeet Bawa, Managing Director and CEO of SAM in the Indian subcontinent. He's also the jury chair for the HR Excellence Award. So thank you, Mr. Bawa, for talking to BW People and BW Business World. And hopefully, with what you've shared, some of the thought processes that the HR leaders have will become even more aligned to the future, if I may say. And mindfulness matters, so we got to be in the present, but being in the present is the best way to prepare for the future. And the HR leaders have made sure that the business continuity planning and execution that needed to happen in the last 12 months has happened well, in alignment with the CEO's vision, and also keeping the employees' welfare at all points of time. So thank you for talking to BW People. We're grateful to you, and we wish you luck in your endeavors. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anurag. Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot.